Hello, this is Annalisa from Faith Dream Crate, and welcome back to my channel. Today I have another St. Patrick's Day themed card for you, and I'll be using this stamp set from Newton's Nook. This is the Newton's Pot of Gold stamp set, but first I'm going to create a background for the card, and I'm going to be doing an alcohol ink background. So I'll have all of the supplies that I used in today's video listed down below. If you are curious and want to take a look at them, this stamp set I believe is no longer available, like Simon Says Stamp. If it is available there, I will link to it, but I will definitely link to it over on Newton's Nook's website. They have it there, and that's where I picked it up, and their shipping is very affordable, even to Canada, which was really, really awesome. Picked up a few stamps on Black Friday that are no longer available over at Simon Says Stamp, so yeah, definitely check out their website. They have a lot of cute images in their stamps that are not available at Simon anymore, or that I've never even seen available at Simon. So just adding the colors into this background, adding some yellows and some greens, and then I do go ahead and add the gold because we're working with the pot of gold. I wanted to have some gold going on in the background. And yeah, so I'm just playing with this using the ink blower and playing with it until I'm happy. I wish that it was lighter, the background. I feel like the image gets a little bit lost at the end, but I still really like how this card turned out. This card definitely is not perfect, and you will see why, and I'll explain that later on, but the process and the creativity, and yeah, I was on an alcohol ink kick. I made some birthday cards around the same time with alcohol ink, and I just had to keep bringing out the alcohol ink. So here is the Newton's Pot of Gold stamp, and I'm just using the Memento Tuxedo Black ink to ink this up, and using a Simon Hurley stamping platform to do that. Then I'm going to go ahead and color this in with Spectrum Norm markers, of course, because those are my go-to coloring, though I just tried out the new Tim Holtz watercolor pencils in some other cards, and I really, really like those, so you might be seeing those more popping up on my channel if I remember to bring them out, but they were really, really fun to work with. So super simple coloring, sticking with those St. Patrick's Day colors for the most part, and then inking up or coloring up this kitty. And then I will fussy cut this guy off camera and keep on rolling with the card. The sentiments on this set are lucky, which is really, really big. Lucky, and then you can pair that with lucky that you're my friend. Lucky to have you. And then there's good luck and happy St. Patrick's Day, and then a little extra clover. Super, super cute. There's so many things you could do with this card, or with this card and with this kitty and the pot of gold, and I can't wait to pull this out again next year as well and switch up the background and make something a little bit lighter. So just adding some details with the Shakura Jelly Roll pen, and this is number 10. I recently got it in a card kit from Simon, and it is way better than the one I was using. It gives you better defined lines. So now that the background is all dry, I'm just using my Tim Holtz paper cutter to trim it down so that I can adhere it to the card when I am ready for that process. Doo-doo-doo. Let's go. I'm just checking to see if it fits onto my card panel, and then I can move on to the next step. So here you can see that the kitty stands out. He looks great. I really like how the kitty stands out on here, but like I said, I wish that the background was a little bit lighter. I don't have a ton of alcohol inks, and yeah, but I really wanted to do an alcohol ink background. It was what was in my head for this card. So now I'm just grabbing out the sentiment, and I'm going to use the Simon Says Stamp clear embossing ink, and I'm just stamping lucky in the back. And then I'm going to use the gold embossing powder. And so this paper, here's where I make a mistake. When I first started alcohol ink, I had some cardstock Yippo paper, and it didn't warp like this. So I have done heat embossing on the Yippo alcohol ink paper before. But for some reason, this is a thinner set, and it was warping it, and in one of the corners, it's a little bit wrinkly. And yeah, so if you are going to do this technique, definitely make sure you have a thicker Yippo paper. As you can see, it's warping, and it's going to get a little wrinkly, and I am able to salvage it, but yeah, it comes out wrinkled in one spot, so use the thicker Yippo paper if you want to do this technique, and add in the heat embossing and that gold finish. I think it still turned out pretty good, but it's not perfect, and I feel like a lot of my card making is not perfect, because who defines perfect in card making? Just create what you love, create the ideas in your head, and make them work. This is going to be for one of my kids, and honestly, they're not going to notice the little wrinkles in the side. They're going to think that that was supposed to be there. They're going to be focused on, ooh, look at the fun, bright colors. Look at the kitty. And if anybody ever comments on, oh, this part isn't perfect on your card, maybe you shouldn't be giving them a card, because that's not kind. We need to be kind, we need to go with the flow, and we need to create what we love, and then we need to learn from our mistakes and get the paper that works for the techniques that we want to try. So now I'm just adhering the kitty. So as you can see, I added Lucky three times down each side, and I love the gold embossing that it brings. And then, of course, this is a Happy St. Patrick's Day card, so I need to bring in Happy St. Patrick's Day. So I'm going to use the sentiment from the set and ink it up on some black. And then, of course, use my white embossing powder to heat set that on here, make it melt, make the sentiment stand out, add a little bit more boldness to this card, and just get that sentiment fussy cut out. And then I can adhere it to the card. And using my advanced tape glider for this. And I use that for the kitty as well. So just sticking it down at the bottom out of the way from the Lucky sentiment that I added as well. And then adding a little bit of shimmer, because spectrum row marker, glitter, yes please, you can't have enough glitter. And then we're almost done, but I felt like I needed to add one more finishing touch to this card. Bring in a little bit more gold. I also did go ahead and add the Spectrum Noir marker over the Happy St. Patrick's Day and add a little bit more sparkle to this card. So then I grabbed my Pops of Color in gold. This also has a little bit of glitter in it, and just added some gold dots along the side here. Totally not necessary, but I really like how it finished it up and gave an element to the white area when there's so much going on in the card, but yet you still have that white balance on the side. So adding the dots in, and then I go ahead and flick it to make them flat and more rounded. And then that is going to finish up today's card. If you like this card, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'd love to have you join me here on my crafting journey as I share what I love to do and hopefully inspire you along the way. And I have more St. Patrick's Day cards coming, and Easter cards, and birthday cards, and all of the cards coming your way. So definitely stick around, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.